Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I've got some really cool things I'm going to show you with adjustment layers. So here we have, it's a picture of a background, and then we've got a foreground where I've already kind of cut her out. And we've got this kind of spy slash Carmen Sandiego thing going on here. So what we want to do is kind of make it match a little bit more. So we're going to grab the top layer and we're going to grab an adjustment layer. So under the adjustment layers, we're going to go down and we're going to choose black and white. This is going to create a black and white adjustment layer. So boom, it comes up on top. Now, what we need to do is open up the properties panel. And then we can make these adjustments. Now notice how these will affect the different colors. So we're affecting just the reds there. And we can go through the different colors and you can see how it's affecting it. Now one of the things you may or may not be noticing right now, as I'm changing this, it's also affecting our background. See that? So maybe we don't want to do that. We just want to affect our layer. So I'm going to show you a couple of ways of doing this. The first way is just to hold down the Alt or the Option key. And notice when we put our mouse pointer in the layers panel, between the two, you see that little arrow. This will do the same thing, but you may not have the properties panel open. So you might just be here and say, you know what, I just want to affect this layer, nothing underneath. Hold down the Alt or the Option and click. And notice what happens. Now it applies it to here. So instead of trickling down through all the layers, it's only going to affect that layer. All right, let's double click this and open it up again, because maybe we want to give it a little bit of a tint. Under tint, click on it. Go down, find the color that we want to sample, you know, it's kind of bluish hue. Click on it there, notice it picks it up from the image, and then we can just apply it like that. So that's a quick way to apply that. All right, so there we go, we've applied that. Now obviously it doesn't quite match, we might have to do some curves. So let's go in here and we're going to go under the adjustment, we're going to create a new adjustment layer. This time we're going to do a curves adjustment. And what we want to do is look at the dark areas and we want to make sure they match here. So we're just going to kind of grab and pull them down. Now notice once again it's affecting everything. So while you're in here, you can just click there and that will clip it, see there, inside the panel. And now we can get those dark areas to be a little bit more moody, contrasty, kind of matching the darks in that area. In fact, let's go more over that way and really kind of push this in. Okay, there we go. Very dark, mysterious. The highlights, maybe we want to push those up a little bit. So we're going for a little bit more of a high contrast kind of a look there. And that's definitely looking a lot better. Things are matching more now. So one of the other things you could do if you just wanted to kind of have fun with this is that we could go in and we could select the black and white. Now, say we wanted to make her hat red. And everything else black and white. You've seen that kind of effect. We'll just select the adjustment layer, that black and white layer. Make sure we select black as the foreground color. And then we're just going to grab our brush. And then all you need to do is just paint it back. See that? I'm not going to make it perfect, but I just want to show you how it can be done. And then you simply just do that. And you can paint it in. You know, if I hit the X key, of course, and then bring it down a little bit, you know, I can clean that up. All right, guys, that was just a quick and easy one for this week. By the way, I do a new tutorial every single week. If you don't want to miss out, hit the subscribe button right now. Become part of the Cafe crew. If you like this tutorial, smash that like button into dust. Become part of the comment squad. Add a comment. Let's get a discussion going. And until next time, I'll see you at the Cafe.